Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, who on that wondrous night sent forth your Son, Jesus Christ, look upon your faithful people gathered in your church tonight, commemorating the Nativity of our Lord in the stable in Bethlehem. Grant, we implore you, that the Savior of the world might be born again in the hearts and souls of all peoples of the world. Unto you we sing and give praise, honor, and glory. And we ask you to instill in us godliness and holy love, strengthen our faith, and grant us your true peace, that peace which we can only find in you. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord. Let us pray. O Lord, on this holy, most holy of all nights, the night when your word was made flesh, a night when the animals and all the objects of nature sang praise unto you, as a symbol of the new creation of Christmas, we look to the evergreen tree, which remains vibrant throughout the winter months, awaiting the opportunity to praise the Son of God at his birth. Bless this Christmas tree, and may we be as vigilant as we await your return. This we ask in the name of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, Christ Jesus. Peace and the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon this creche, and may all who partake of viewing the infant Jesus and the Holy Family be moved to a greater devotion and love. May the peace and blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon this Christmas tree, a reminder of life, and may it bring blessing to all those who partake. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Light and peace in Jesus Christ our Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Today is Christmas Eve, in which we recall the hope we have in Christ. Today we light again the candles of hope, peace, joy, and love. The first candle. We speak of hope because God keeps his promises to us. The second candle. We work for peace because Jesus is the Prince of Peace, and he calls his children to work for peace in his name. The third candle, we show love because Jesus gave everything for us and led us to know the forgiveness of God. The fourth candle, we share joy because the Holy Spirit fills our hearts and minds with the presence of God. And now, we light our last candle to remember the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. As the prophets promised so long ago, you have come to us once again, and with the shepherds, we are filled with wonder and amazement. Let us pray. Lord, you came into this world as a tiny, fragile baby. Yet we know that you are God and that you are with us tonight. May the flame of this candle remind us that you are the light of the world, and that if we follow you, we will never walk in darkness, but will have the true light of life. Come, Lord Jesus, come. Amen. Thank you. Hid midnight silence. Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We will go into the altar of God. Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. My dear brothers and sisters, let us go before God, our Heavenly Father, and make an examination of our conscience, that the gifts that we are to present unto God this evening, on this, the Christmas vigil, might be accepted by Him through our love that we have for Him. And now, please make an examination of your conscience. And now, my brothers and sisters, let us recite together the second form of the act of confession. I confess to Almighty God, one in the Holy Trinity, in the presence of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned in thought, word, and deed, by my own great fault. I ask the Blessed Mother Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us unto life everlasting.
Amen.
May the Almighty and merciful Lord grant us pardon, absolution, and the remission of our sins.
Amen.
May our Lord Jesus Christ absolve you, and with his authority vested in me by him, I absolve you of your sins. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O God, you will again renew us. Show us your mercy, Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Take our sins away from us, Lord, so that we might enter the Holy of Holies with purified hearts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord all the earth. Sing to the Lord, bless his name, announce salvation day after day.
Tell us, Lord, among the nations, among all people, his marvelous deeds.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, We praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, Holy Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you. Heavenly Father, you make this holy night radiant with the splendor of Jesus Christ, the long-awaited Messiah. We welcome him as Lord, our light, the true light of the whole world. May he bring us to eternal joy in the kingdom of heaven. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the prophet Isaiah. The people who walk in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing. As they rejoice before you as at the harvest, as people make merry when dividing spoils. For the yoke that burdened them, the pull on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaster. You have smashed on as on the day of Midian. For every boot that tramped in battle, every cloak rolled in blood will be burned as fuel for flames. For a child is born to us, a son is given us. Upon his shoulder, dominion rests. They name him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful, from David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response for this evening's Mass is, today is born our Savior, Christ the Lord.
Today is born our Savior, Christ the Lord.
Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all you lands. Sing to the Lord. Bless his name.
Today is born our Savior, Christ the Lord.
Announce his salvation day after day. Tell his glory among the nations, among all peoples his wondrous deeds.
Today is born our Savior, Christ the Lord.
Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice. Let the sea and what fills it resound. Let the plains be joyful and all that is in them. Then shall all the trees of the forest exult.
Today is born our Savior, Christ the Lord.
They shall exult before the Lord, for he comes, to rule the earth. He shall rule the world with justice and the peoples with his constancy.
Today is born our Savior, Christ the Lord.
The second reading is from the letter of St. Paul the Apostle to Titus. Beloved, the grace of God has appeared, saving all and training us to reject godless ways and worldly desires, to live temperately, justly, and devoutly in this age, as we await the blessed hope, the appearance of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to deliver us from all the lawlessness and to cleanse for himself a people at his own, eager to do what is good. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice. Let the sea and what fills it resound. Let the plains be joyful of all that is in them.
Come before God, all the earth, say among the nations, the Lord is King.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
I will proclaim the decree of the Lord who said to me, "You are my son. Today I am your father."
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Almighty and eternal God, who cleansed the lips of the prophet Isaiah with a burning coal, cleanse my heart and my lips through your gracious mercy, that I may worthily proclaim your holy gospel through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the Lord be in my heart and on my lips, that I may worthily proclaim his holy gospel. Amen. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the whole world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment when Quirinius was governor of Syria. So they all went to be enrolled, each to his own town. And Joseph too went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David that is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, to be enrolled with Mary his betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were shepherds in that region, living in the field, and keeping the night watch over their flock. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were struck with great fear. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. For behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that will be for all people. For today, in the city of David, a Savior has been born for you, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was a multitude of heavenly hosts with the angel praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to the Lord Jesus
Christ. I believe in one God,
the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in fulfillment of the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The
Lord be with you. heavens be glad and the earth rejoice before the Lord who comes to govern the earth, to govern the world with justice and the peoples with faithfulness. And sisters, that our gifts of love and sacrifice may truly be accepted by God, our Heavenly Father. Amen. Let us pray. Eternal Father, accept our gifts on this joyful feast of our salvation. By our communion with God made man, may we become more like him who joins our lives to yours. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Thanks unto the Lord our God. to give you thanks through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. You showed us your great love by sending your only begotten Son to live among us. Today we honor those humble shepherds who were the first to hear and proclaim the glad tidings of his birth, of Jesus, who announced by a heavenly host. You who strengthened them and increased your church by calling men to shepherd your people and to witness the good news of salvation. Therefore, with the angels and archangels, with all the saints and the entire church, we lift our hymn of praise to your glory, repeating very humbly. Please be seated. Most merciful Father, we most humbly pray and ask you through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, to accept and to bless these gifts, these presents, these holy and spotless sacrifices, which we offer up to you in the first place for your holy Catholic Church, that you would guide it in peace, defense, and unity throughout the whole world with its bishops and priests, especially Anthony, our Prime Bishop, and Paul, our Bishop, and all who profess the true Orthodox and Catholic faith which comes to us from the Apostles. Remember your servants, O Lord. And all here present, whose faith and devotion are known to you, for whom we offer, who offer up to you the sacrifice of praise for themselves and all their own, for their hope of salvation and deliverance, and who freely choose to serve you, the living, eternal, and true God, we join in communion with and honor above all others the memory of Mary, the glorious mother of our Lord and God, Jesus Christ. Also your blessed apostles, martyrs, and confessors, together with all the countless number of saintly men and women of all nations, but especially of our nation, who lived, suffered, and died for the glory of your name and the coming of your kingdom. May the remembrance of these praiseworthy people encourage us to follow their heroic example, making us worthy of your grace and love through the same Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We ask you, Lord, to graciously accept our offering and that of your whole family, and so order our days in your peace, that we may be saved from spiritual damnation and counted among the flock of your chosen people. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, we ask you to bless, to accept, and to confirm this offering, and to make it pleasing to yourself, so that it may be filled with the power of the Holy Spirit and become for us the body and the blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. The day before his suffering and death, in order to manifest his infinite love to his disciples and through them to all who would believe in him, to fill the hearts of his followers with the fire of this love, draw them unto himself, make them joyful, and save them, he instituted these holy mysteries. He was spiritually and bodily in his entire being, again lives among his people. At that solemn moment, so sacred for the whole human family, our Savior took bread into his holy and venerable hands, and having lifted his eyes to heaven, to you, his almighty Father, giving thanks to you, he blessed it, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which is given for you." in like manner after supper, taking this excellent chalice into his holy and venerable hands, again he gave thanks to you, blessed it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which shall be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you do these things, do them in remembrance of me. Therefore, in remembrance of this Christ, your Son, our Lord, in his blessed passion, resurrection, and his glorious ascension, we, your servants and faithful people, offer to your divine majesty from your own gifts and presents a pure offering, a holy offering, an immaculate offering, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to regard these offerings with favor and joy, and accept them as you receive the gifts of your just servant Abel, the sacrifice of our patriarch Abraham, and that which our high priest Melchizedek offered you, a holy sacrifice and immaculate host. We humbly ask you, Almighty God, command that this offering be brought by the hands of your holy angel to your high altar, into the presence of your divine majesty, that we who receive the most sacred body and blood of your Son from this altar may be filled with every blessing and grace, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, remember your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and who now sleep in peace. To these souls, Lord, and all who rest in Christ, we pray a place of refreshment, light, and peace, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. And grant us, your sinful servants who hope in the greatness of your mercy, some part in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs and all your saints who shed their blood for your name. Their hearts were always open to justice and mercy, and with lives patterned after their divine master, merited eternal joy. Numbers in their company, Lord, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses, through Christ our Lord. Amen. By whom you always create, sanctify, revive, bless, and freely give us all these good things. Through him, with him, in him, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray. Instructed by our Savior's teaching, and following divine example, we say with confidence,
Amen.
Thank you.
present and future, and by the intercession of the blessed and glorious Mother of God, Mary, together with your blessed apostles, Peter and Paul, and also Andrew and all the saints, grant us peace in our day. Supported by the help of your mercy, may we always be free from sin and secure from all disturbance. Through the same Jesus Christ, your Son and our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
May this commingling and consecration of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ help us to receive it to everlasting life. Amen. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Do not look at our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, for you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, your death brought life to the world. By your holy body and blood, free us from all our sins and from every evil. Keep us faithful to your teaching, and never let us be parted from you, who lives and reigns God forever and ever. Amen. May the partaking of your body and blood, Lord Jesus, not be cause for our judgment or condemnation. Though we are unworthy to receive this great sacrament, through your loving kindness may become our safeguard and healing remedy, our saving master. Awaken in us a living faith, fervent love, worship, adoration, and a holy longing. Through this communion, make us your willing servants, zealous to fulfill your holy will. May it at last unite us entirely with you, our Lord and our God. Grant this, who lives and reigns with God the Father in the unity with the Holy Spirit, forever and ever. Amen. I will take the heavenly bread, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. May the body of our Lord Jesus Christ preserve my soul unto life everlasting. Amen. What shall I return unto the Lord for all the graces he hath rendered unto me? I will take the chalice of salvation, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. With high praise will I call upon him, and I shall be saved from all my enemies. May the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ preserve my soul unto life everlasting. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Lord,
I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed.
Jesus Christ. pleasure before the day star, like the dew I begot you. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. God our Father, in receiving this Eucharist, we rejoice in the birth of our Savior. May we share his life completely by living as he had taught. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Be pleasing to you, most holy Trinity. Grant that the sacrifice which we, though unworthy, have offered in the sight of your majesty be acceptable to you. Through your mercy, may be effective for ourselves and for all those for whom we have offered it. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the Almighty and merciful God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. In the beginning was the Word was in God's presence, and the Word was God. He was present to God in the beginning. Through him all things came into being, and apart from him nothing came to be. Whatever came to be in him found life, life for the light of men. The light shines on in the darkness, a darkness that did not overcome it. There was a man named John, sent by God, who came as a witness to testify to the light, so that through him all might believe, but only to testify to the light, for he himself was not the light. The real light, which gives light to every man who is coming into the world. He was in the world, and through him the world was made, yet the world did not know who he was. To his own he came, yet his own did not accept him. Any who did accept him, he empowered to become children of God. These are they who believe in his name, who were begotten not by blood, nor by carnal desire, nor by man's willing it, but by God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory of an only Son coming from the Father, filled with enduring love. Thanks be to God. May the name of Jesus be praised by all of us, now and forevermore. Amen. Yek benjapa phalani Jesus Christus. I welcome you to church this evening as we have the Christmas vigil, as we prepare to celebrate Christmas, or as we also know as Christ Mass. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. My brothers and sisters, I'm not going to speak long, but I would like to share with you a few thoughts. You know, when our Lord came into the world, he didn't come into the world with pomp and ceremony. There were no marching bands, but there was an angel. And it is interesting to note that the majority of people, according to their faith, believe that there are such things as angels. And so when our world came to a time in which God sent his Son into the world, he sent his Son to bring hope to a world that lived in darkness. And if there is at any time that we need to have light in our world, it is now. You know, there are going to be many who doubt the story of the Nativity because they cannot wrap their minds around something that they cannot explain scientifically. But as we read Holy Scripture, as we reflect upon the candles of Advent, that there was a hope and a longing that things could be better in the world, that God would make himself known to the people so that they might be able to have that light. And we read this in the last gospel about the true light that came into the world, and that those who believe in him will become children of God. You know, this evening we have what is known as the Mass of the Shepherds. In all the humbleness of this birth, the first ones to have heard of this miracle birth were the lowly shepherds. In all humility, they sought the Messiah. They looked to the skies so that their world that they lived in could be a lot brighter. In my Christmas bulletin, there's a poem that I found that I think kind of brings to mind the lowliness of his birth, but yet in his lowliness, there was greatness. And so please reflect on these words. It's a poem called New Prince, New Pomp by Robert Southwell. Behold a silly, tender babe in freezing winter night, in homely manger trembling lies, alas, a pitiful sight. The inns are full. No man will yield this little pilgrim bed, but forced he is with silly beasts in crib to shroud his head. Despite him, not for lying there, first for what is inquire, an orient pearl is often found in depth of dirty mire. Weigh not his crib, his wooden dish, nor beast that by him fed. Weigh not his mother's poor attire, nor Joseph's simple deed. The stable is a prince's court, the crib his chair of state. The beasts are parcel of his pomp, the wooden dish his plate. The persons in that poor attire, his royal liveries wear. The prince himself is come from heaven. This pomp is prized there. With joy approach, O Christ-filled knight, do homage to thy King, and highly prize this humble pomp which he from heaven doth bring. It is in our simplicity, it is in our humility, that Christ comes unto those who truly seek him. And what better way than to celebrate the birth of this child in all poverty and simple surroundings, that he came to bring light to you and to me. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. I wish to thank, first of all, my dear brother Wayne. You look good with your new addition. You deserve it, Wayne, and God's blessings. And especially this evening, for Aaron and for Braden Tudrin, who gave of their time to come and to celebrate at the altar of God on this Christmas Eve. To the members of our choir, who gave such beautiful renditions of Christmas song, and we've talked about it on several occasions, that hymns are actually prayers, two times blessed. And to my dear friend, as we know, Santa, and his wife, who came and took the time to visit. And I was joking around with a couple of our people that, dear Santa, we thank you for coming this evening, and we know that your sleigh is double parked in our back lot. So God's blessings be with you and all of you. God's blessings. May the Christ be born in your heart in all the simplicity. It is a time that when we wonder what Christmas is about, look at your loved ones, look at your children, look at your grandchildren, and believe in his most holy name. God bless you.